All right, I'm going to show you my electric motor here. Here we got my homemade control box and my amp meter and my volt meter. And down here, that's the controller. And there's the contactor and the fuse. And there's the motor. Oh, and there's the reduction gearbox. And here's my battery bank, the gas tank. But what I got here is 8 GC2 golf cart batteries from Sam's Club. And this bank is about 220 amp hours at 48 volts. All right, y'all ready to go for a little boat ride? Here we go. Notice I'm not even bothering to start my motor. I know it's gonna start. Take this one off. I gotta put the camera down. Okay, here we go. Little reverse power here. All right, here we go. Let's see, let me power this thing right on down. Ah, that's an amp there. That's about 1 amp. Now, most people in sheltered, protected waters, they use way too much power. But they really ain't got much choice. Most diesel or gasoline engines, they idle at like 700 RPM, 650, 700, 750. Well, I don't have a minimum idle speed. I can go all the way down to all 5 or 10 RPM if I want and just creep along. And it's still moving right along. Still doing almost a knot. All right, I guess I'll kick it in the ass and get on out to the lake. That's 10 amps. That'll give me about 2.5 knots once I get her wound up here. Now I'm using a square wave type controller, so it's making a lot more noise, the motor is, than it would be if I was using a sine wave controller. But that's alright. It's all good. It's still quieter than a diesel or a gas engine. I don't have any shielding around the engine. Nothing between this microphone and the engine except nothing. If I close up the house here, it's pretty quiet out here. Yeah, I guess that's about 2.5 knots. 2.6, something like that. Just thumbnail estimate. No wake, of course.